Our next movie is based on the classic children's book by E.B. White. Stuart Little, in the movie Mr. and Mrs. Little, played by Gina Davis and Hugh Laurie, go to an orphanage to adopt a child and meet Stuart, warmly voiced by Michael J. Fox.
You know what's wonderful? What's wonderful is how you both know what the other one is going to say before you even say it. Not that it's any of my business.
When the Littles bring Stuart home, he meets another member of the household, Snowbell, their cat. Snowbell is hilariously voiced by Nathan Lane.
You seem tense.
Tense? Oh, I'm way past tense.
Well, maybe I can help. What do you like? Can I scratch your ears?
I can rub your tummy.
How'd you like to rub it from the inside, mouse boy?
Stuart also runs into resistance with the little son, George, played by Jonathan Lipnicki.
I'm not really sure I want a brother.
Oh. Well, how about a friend?
I guess I could always use a friend.
This film makes poignant observations with gentle humor, as in this scene where Stuart poses for the family portrait.
What's wrong?
Well, you four look great together.
This is the happiest moment of my life. I feel 10 inches tall.
That scene sums it up. Stuart Little finds a charming balance of all its elements. There are lovable characters with real problems who find truthful, never cute, answers to questions about identity, family, loyalty. Most commendable of all, though, is the way state-of-the-art technology here is used to support, rather than overwhelm, a very tender story, and to create in one little mouse a living, breathing, three-dimensional character with enormous humanity.
I hated this movie
more
than you hated the first one. And I'll tell you why.
Why?
Stuart Little is only a mouse. Now, in the book, he expands psychically to take up as much space as the human characters. But in the movie, he looks grotesque and bizarre at every moment. They tuck him in, and he doesn't even need the hem of the blanket to cover himself up. He is so small and vulnerable that at no point was I able to see this movie as anything other than an extremely sad and peculiar story about these people who thought they had adopted a child and they have adopted a two-inch rodent.
First of all, you're never laboring under the misapprehension that they think they've adopted one thing and have something else. It's just presented as a very normal thing, and I thought I couldn't accept it. But within 30 seconds of looking at Stuart, I never saw a mouse. I only saw Stuart. And I think that while you may have read the book, and it's unavoidable to make that comparison, it's not entirely fair.
No, a
book works on a whole different canvas. You need to use a whole different set of criteria.
I know.
This works as a book,
but it doesn't work as a movie. And little Stuart, with his piping little voice and his preppy little jacket, struck me as somebody who belonged in an all-mouse version of The Great Gatsby.
No, it answers a lot of questions that people have today about what makes up a family.
Later in the show, Robin Williams plays a robotic bicentennial man.
I saw the inner me.
Coming up next, Jodie Foster in Anna and the King.
You cannot shut the world out forever.